So, Mr. Cheney, this is your first time on Meet the Press with David Gregory.
It is.
Great. Now, how do you like your makeup?
Enough color so I don't look like a corpse, but not so much that it looks like I have feelings.
Okay. So can I get you to close your eyes for me?
Hey, makeup lady, give me that brush. So, are you excited about doing the show?
Hello, Mr. President.
Oh, damn, Dick. You are impossible to surprise. What's your secret?
Well, Mr. President, for one, you whisper too loud.
Yeah, it's always been a problem of mine. That is one of the many reasons that I am no friend to libraries.
So what are you doing here, Mr. President?
Well, Dick, I've been contacted by members of the GOP who've asked me to speak to you about your newfound love of the media spotlight.
I have been making some television appearances.
Some? You're on TV more than that ShamWow guy.
Well, I understand this visibility is a bit of a change for me.
Yeah, no dud of the max, Dick. I mean, I spent 8 years with my face out there saying things I barely understood. Well, you were nowhere to be found.
I was busy.
Yeah, bravo on what you were busy with, by the way. People seem to be really psyched about it.
If you're referring to our interrogation policies, Mr. President, I have no regrets.
Yeah, well, here is my regret, that I didn't have me a vice president like Joe Biden. I mean, look at those two going out for burgers. Laughing it up. I need that kind of VP, the kind that did dumb stuff to make me look smarter. You know? Instead, I got the one guy that scares me more than my dad.
We had a different chemistry, sir.
Yeah, the chemistry of acid in the face. Dick, it's over. We need to move on.
We have a legacy to protect. What would you have me do, Mr. President?
Just stick to our plan. Let's let history be the judge, okay? It's an awesome plan because history takes forever.
There are things I think the American people need to know, sir.
But I don't want you to tell them those things, okay? Just like you probably wouldn't want me to tell people certain things, like the time you were dead for 3 days.
No.
No. Now, sir, nothing. You were straight up dead, okay? We were gonna bury you, but Colin Powell said, let's give it one more day. I mean, Colin's the reason you're here. So I don't like it when you run him down.
Well, I would hate for the story about my unfortunate,
death, the word is death,
to go public.
Okay, so then we're in agreement, okay? You cool it with the world tour, and I'll keep my mouth shut. By the way, they still only know about the one face shooting.
Now, Mr. President,
I'm not scared of you anymore, Dick. Okay? I've been watching a ton of Dr. Phil.
Very well, sir.
And hey, I'm sorry to be a red ass about it.
I understand.
If you ever want to Biden it up and get a burger with me, I'm game.
Yes, sir.
All right, I'll see you later, Dick.
And Mr. President, one last thing.
Yeah?
Live from New York, it's Saturday night!